Maybe 10 years ago, if you had asked me, do you think I have the potential to create a huge impact in the pharma industry and save the lives of thousands of people, maybe potentially save hundreds or thousands of crores for pharma companies, I would have said, you're out of your mind. I would have said, I'm just a guy who loves to play guitar. What are you talking about, you know, all this stuff? I would have said that. But the beauty is this journey has happened so naturally. It's not that I psyched myself up to achieve bigger things in life. No. It happened very naturally. Antano and Harini are that what they do is change people's lives, irrespective of their background, whether they're businessmen or whether they're athletes or actors, whatever they may be, they know how to help you change your life, to help you reach where you want, or maybe help you even to reach where you even don't know that such a possibility exists. You know, the people who have the potential to create amazing positive impact in the world, they're giving them that. I think that is the gift that they're giving. Just, there's no way you can measure that in monetary terms. I don't think you can do it. It all started actually a couple of years back, around 6 years ago, when we got invited by a couple of very big pharma companies to handle a very dangerous problem. Many people may not be aware that manufacturing medicines is actually a very hazardous profession. I've seen the CCTV footage of the actual accidents that the customer shared with me. And it looks completely innocent. I mean, no one threw a lit cigarette or a matchstick into the chemical or anything. And it looks totally unbelievable. Some people are just going about their day-to-day jobs, just doing what they do normally every single day of their daily life in their work. And that thing just explodes. And each time so many people die, there's damage to property. Medicine worth a few hundred crores is gone. It's burnt. You can't recover it anymore. There's a lot of dangers involved. In fact, it's strange to know that a lot of things which can heal you can also kill you. Around 6 years ago, these pharma companies, they invited me, all expenses paid, to investigate what could have happened, what are my suggestions and solutions. When I went there, this was my challenge. I realized that the problem is not the scientific explanation, it's a matter of changing beliefs. So with that perspective, once I started explaining to people that this doesn't help, your problem is not solved every single day. It's not a question of if you will have an accident, it's just a question of when you will have another accident. And each time so many people die, there's damage to property. Medicine worth a few hundred crores is gone. It's burnt. You can't recover it anymore. And the entire production factory itself, sometimes it burns down. If the factory burns down, unless you construct a new factory for the next 1 or 2 years it takes, there's nothing. There's no business for the company at all. So I started out to solve this particular problem, and I designed a very effective solution at that time. And the interesting thing was, yes, we solved that particular problem. People saw and monitored that these type of materials, which had a history of accidents in the sense that almost every month there used to be a fire. Every month. And they had gotten used to it. It was kind of like accepted, oh, you're going to manufacture that particular product, you're going to have a fire, just keep everything ready to put it out. Now the problem here was the defeatism. That people just accepted that you can't do anything about it. It's just going to happen. Someone is going to die, okay? And you're going to have to handle that fire and you have to put it out, that's it. That was the mindset which I set out to change. The technology part of it, which I had on what was the solution, was actually the easy part. As the days went along, a very strange discovery started coming out. Pharma companies, I have to tell you, by nature, are a very conservative market. even if you tell them that there is a technology that you have which can solve every single problem that they have ever experienced, tell them you'll give it for free, they will not use it. It's a very conservative market. I had difficulty understanding why would someone behave like this. And I started to realize as I went along, it's a very complex industry in the sense that every single, if they change even a small nut or a bolt in their machine, they have to document it inside their approval from the US FDA. So after a lot of, you know, back and forth, finally they went ahead with a lot of, you know, scare about what's going to happen, what will be the impact of the quality by installing your technology on our machines. And then they called me back after a few months and said, you know, there has been an impact on the quality of the product after installing your equipment. Every product that we're manufacturing now, the quality has improved. They're like, what is the connection? We did this to improve the safety, and yes, it served that purpose. We're super happy about it. But how is it that all the medicines manufactured using your technology have improved their quality? What is the science behind it? I was also surprised when I first heard about it. But as I started thinking deeper and deeper, it started to occur that yes, it was like I had opened up not a Pandora's box, something a very positive box. An industry which is full of scientists that for decades they know that the problem exists. It's common across pharma industry, these type of rejections, but they don't actually know the root cause. Well-known problem, but the root cause is not understood. It was all connected to electrostatics, which I started uncovering. It was a beautiful process of discovery. Each time this came up, people said, hey, you know, it solved one more problem. What is the connection with your technology? I'm like, oh, this is amazing. I never expected this to happen. And I kept developing scientific explanations for each one of them, how it's actually helping. And I did that, and people saw it, and they monitored first for 6 months to see, and they saw that this was the first time in their history that for 6 months there was no fire in those products. And some people in that organization were very proactive, helpful. Once they saw the usefulness of the technology, the head of safety of that particular company, he said, standardize it across all factories. I don't want any debates about anything else. We've seen the solution now after waiting for decades. I've been waiting for decades for someone to come along and solve this problem. Every time we had an accident, people said it's static charge. So the management had almost reached sometimes a point of frustration. Why don't we just stop making the medicine? What are we dealing with here? Like, you know, struggling with accidents all the time. Every year people die, there's injuries, the factory gets damaged. The government comes in for an inquiry why it happened. The union starts fighting about it. Maybe we should just stop making the medicine. Doctors said, you can't do that. People will die on the streets. This medicine is really important. You can't just stop making the medicine because you have these problems. So with this kind of background, while I was very, very happy about the fact that we solved the problem for them and we got, you know, good business, I'm very happy about the fact that not just about earning money, that the work that I did saved the lives of so many people. Even as we speak, whatever has been installed in those factories is still continuing to save the lives of people who are working over there, which was fantastic. So when I shared this with Antano, his immediate question was, all of this, yes, he was happy to hear all of this, but his question was, before you talk about anything else, have you patented it? I was like, not really. I haven't gone into much thought about that aspect of whether I should patent. And Antano said, I refuse to give you another consultation until you file for a patent. So, I mean, I wanted to speak about a few more things with him, but he was like, I don't refuse to talk about anything else. No consultation until you finish filing for a patent, and then we will discuss further. Now, I have always had huge respect for both Antano and Harini, and I know that whatever they told me has worked out wonders, both in my personal life and business. Whatever they have given me, those advices, the practices, it's been fantastic. So I filed for the patent and everything. The next time, as soon as I met Antano, the first question he asked me was, have you filed for the patent? Otherwise, don't talk about anything else. I said, yes, I have. And then he said, okay, I want to know more about what's been happening. Now, it turned out more good news had started coming in. This technology that I had implemented for safety, which was great, it worked well, and I had already filed for a patent. The process was going on. So he said, why are you stuck in an idea that you only have to sell a product to these companies? I was like, because it is a product. He agreed and said, yes, I know it is a product. But do you realize that it's something far more than a product that you're selling to them? the fact that a single technology can solve a safety problem as well as improve the quality of their products. And it was like, what was the actual improvement in the quality in financial terms? He said, find out. You know, they said it improved the quality of their medicines that was being manufactured. Financially, can you give them some kind of, measurement about what was the money saved in the quality improvement? I found out that the quality problem which it's solving is causing them to lose between 500 to 1000 crores every year. And it's accepted in the balance sheet as a normal expense. That we lose this much of medicine every year due to this problem, it's a normal thing. It's been happening since the last 30, 40 years, so it's normal. Now, this type of problem solving, which when I realized the impact of it, and I asked him, is this normal to you that you lose like 1000 crores? He said, yeah, it's been happening. And it's not a bad year, Kishore, last year. 1000 crores is not bad. I was like, do you have even worse scenarios? He said, yeah, like 3 years back, it was totally bad. We did not understand at the time what was the reason. But yeah, that year, I think we lost almost 3000 crores due to that problem. I was, okay, this is unbelievable. How do people normalize this? And there wasn't anything. There was no hint of emotion in their voice. There was no frustration. There was no, sadness that the company lost 3000 crores. They're like, hey, it keeps happening. Now, I think this is where we need to talk about whether it's a problem with the science or whether it's a problem with states. Yeah, states. So once someone believes that nothing can be done about the problem, then the unconscious just closes off and says, nothing can be done about the problem, accept it as normal. Once I heard this, yeah, absolutely, I was shocked to hear the impact about this. And that's when Antano suggested that maybe it's not a product that you're selling them, but you're selling them a solution which is worth a few thousand crores at least. And you should figure out a way to pitch this in a different way, maybe, that you're giving them a technology, a license to use a patented technology which can solve these kind of problems. The fact that that technology is both saving the lives of people who are manufacturing medicine, it's also saving the medicine itself. It's saving, the money also for people from losing so much due to these problems. I mean, I would have never imagined like 10 years back that my life had a potential to create this kind of impact. Antano and Harini, are they like that? What they do is change people's lives. Irrespective of their background, whether they're businessmen or whether they're athletes or actors, whatever they may be, they know how to help you change your life, to help you reach where you want, or maybe help you even to reach where you even don't know that such a possibility exists. To help you understand that, there's something far beyond what you were thinking is possible. There's something much beyond that. And it's not always about monetary terms. It's not just about, I used to think I can earn 1 lakh a month, because of them I can earn 5 lakhs a month. I think that's too small an impact. I think that's a given. With the work that they're doing, I think that is a natural outcome, that obviously I think you can expect that your income will increase. But I think there's also something far beyond that. Your social life increases, you make better friends, you make more meaningful connections with people. You start to understand how all of this is connected with your health and well-being, and you make sure that you learn how to design your life holistically. Because I would say that when they opened up these capabilities with me, maybe 10 years ago, if you had asked me, do you think I have the potential to create a huge impact in the pharma industry and save the lives of thousands of people, maybe potentially save hundreds or thousands of crores for pharma companies, I would have said, you're out of your mind. I would have said, I'm just a guy who loves to play guitar. What are you talking about, all this stuff? I would have said that. But the beauty is, this journey has happened so naturally. It's not that I psyched myself up to achieve bigger things in life. No, it happened very naturally. I think it's something that's beautiful that I go out and create every single day, because that joy is there. It gives me, excited in the morning. When I wake up in the morning, I never feel like, oh my God, I have to go to the office today. I always feel like, oh my God, I get to go to the office today and do all of these wonderful things. It's a huge difference, right? So I think this is the massive impact. The fact that you never have to work again a single day in your life, you get to enjoy every single day what you do. You get to create a huge impact, positive impact on a lot of people with what you do. I think the world is unfortunately full of an imbalance where there's so many people who have all the resources to create impact and they use it to create the wrong kind of impact. I think it's amazing that what the work that Anton and Harini are doing is giving that power to the right kind of people. You know, the people who have the potential to create amazing positive impact in the world, they're giving them that creativity, that urge to make your life that kind of artistic pursuit. I think that is the gift that they have given. Just, and there's no way you can measure that in monetary terms. I don't think you can do it. It's incredible. You can measure other things in monetary terms, like whatever business I've done, you can measure like how much business did I do, how much profit did I make. You can. It's important to do that, but I think this is even beyond that. Just incredible, that gift. So thanks to both of them. Eternally grateful to them. It's just amazing that the world has people like this to show us the path.